بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اهتدى بهديه واقتدى بسنته إلى يوم الدين وبعد. Welcome back. Here we are with a good Muslim on behalf of the SMA as well. So with only one day remaining for what they call Valentine's Day, what should be Yom al-Hub, the day of love, I think it's really important that we should have at least a little understanding of exactly what it is. In all honesty, just like many of the other celebrations that we're taught about and we're told about when we were kids in school, and which most of which have become commercialized anyhow, this was also, its roots goes back to a pagan custom. It was a pagan ritual. And in case you didn't know, this is how it works. So what happens is many guys would get together, and after getting together, they would take the names of many of girls, and they would put these names inside of an urn, kind of like a vase. Some people would pronounce it a vase. And after putting the names inside there, they would come and randomly pick one name out. And whosoever name, whichever girl's name came out of the urn, that is the girl that particular individual, that man, would spend the rest of that festival with. He would continue to date this girl like this, and the following year, that person would then get engaged to her. This was promiscuous. This is nonsense, and this is completely not acceptable in Islam. So when Christianity finally came to Rome, we're looking at quite a while ago, perhaps 756, if I can remember the year correctly, during that time anyhow. So that practice used to happen every year on the 15th of February. Yes, the 15th. When Christianity comes to Rome, what the people then do now is they say, I guess they realize this isn't anything good. So they kind of bring about a twist to this, and they change it for what I would consider the better. And what they would do now is they would take the names of their saints, and they would place them inside of this vase, inside of this urn, and then they would withdraw. They would take out the names. And these names, so any name that you took out, that you drew out from this urn, that saint is the one that you would try to emulate. You would try to be like, you would try to copycat, you would try to look up to, and you know. So you would emulate the saint. And this was amazing. So this continued for some time. But because this is pretty good, Shaitan wasn't going to have it. Ultimately, what happened? They went right back to their old custom. In countries like, I think it was Italy and France, it was banned. And then later on, anyhow, it became commercialized. And this is what we see today. And oh yeah, will you be my Valentine? That, if you've ever heard it before, hopefully not. But if you have, what is the origin of this? So there's this bishop, he falls in love with a jailer's daughter, and he writes to her this amazing letter, and he signs off by writing, "Your Valentine." So that's the origin of that. And that Cupid that we see all the time, that Cupid there is supposed to be like the daughter of Venus. And who's Venus? The god of love. Hold on a minute. Allah is the Lord of everything. Everything and everything. And Yom al-Hub, the day of love, is every day and every day in the life of a believer. Our love for Allah, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. Our love for the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Oh, learn it from the Sahaba. يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهِ إِنِّي لَأُحِبُّكَ. Our love for our neighbors, not enough emphasis. I mean, there's so much that we could tell you about the importance Islam gives. Loving your neighbors, loving your kith and kin, your brothers and sisters, your relatives, your uncles and aunts. And then, of course, our parents. Wow. And finally, the love, that special love that Allah places inside of the hearts for one's spouse. That's something that we have for one another every single day, not just particularly on the 14th of February. No. So keep this in mind and be a loving person. Love others and you shall be loved. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Al-mu'minu ya'laf wa yu'laf. Wala khayra fi man la ya'laf wa la yu'laf. A believer loves and a believer is loved. And there's no good in somebody that doesn't love and somebody that isn't loved. And oh yeah, finally, if you do love someone for the sake of Allah, you tell them, I love you for the sake of Allah. And my friends, don't be telling this to people of other genders just because it's the teaching of the Prophet. This applies to somebody that you're allowed to love. If you love them, I love you. And I love all of you for the sake of Allah. Stay tuned. We'll continue tomorrow. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.